你翻，当他给你翻译，你给他就是给他打开那个麦。
哦，好的。
待会儿当他给你翻译，对，谢谢，
好，
好，工
待
作
会
辛
儿
苦，
喝呗。
拜拜。
你可以自己开麦。当然可以。
开着了，不。
好。我们欢迎各位来到我们的会议房间。
OK，我们开始。
好，那个是马老师，
Hare
请说，
Krishna。
那个人不给你解释。
My essences. How are you, Tanakeli?
I'm good.
Are you at home?
Yes, I'm home now.
Oh, you got so many books at home.
No, actually, that's a Janaka problem. It's not me. I don't have my video on because I saw the other translators not have their videos on, so I also, you know, decided to keep it shut.
Okay, so we'll begin.
那我们现在开始。
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Gaur Chandra Jaya Bhaktavinda.
Hey, you got it wrong, Danakeli.
Oh.
Jai
Sorry.
Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavrinda.
Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavrinda.
Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda.
Jaya Sri
Chaitanya Jaya
Nityananda Jaya Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavinda. There was no Dvaita Chandra. I'm sorry, sorry, Maharaj. I'm confused.
No, you were okay. It was Janaka wrong. You were correct the second time. Okay, so this morning we were hearing about Lord Chaitanya's visit to the Shakshi Gopal temple.
那今天早晨呢，我们听到了主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 拜访了沙奇贡帕庙。
And then we heard about the journey coming to Jagannath Puri temple.
然后呢，我们又听到了 who is that? Sorry, Marge, I didn't hear the who.
Their journey.
The
we heard about their journey. They're traveling towards the temple.
然后呢，我们又听到了他们去到了，就是一起旅行去到了Jagannath Puri 的庙。
And then who remembers what happened to Lord Chaitanya's danda?
大家有谁还记得主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的那根丹丹棒发生了什么故事？
Anybody?
他的那个丹丹棒被 Nityananda 折成三段，扔到河里去了。
Yes, thank you. So, why did Lord Nityananda break the danda?
那为什么主 Nityananda 把他的这个丹达棒给折断了呢？
There were two reasons, right?
有两个原因，对吧？
Anybody remember?
其中一个原因是，因为主你恰当的本人就是这个至尊主，他就不一般都是到了那个巴兰哈姆萨，就不拿萨亚西布尔了，初期的时候拿，到了巴兰哈姆萨阶段就不拿萨亚西布尔了，但是， 朱尼切呢，朱齐泰纳已经是他是智中国人，他远远高于那个层次，所以他不需要拿这个萨尼亚西布尔。他的意思呢
？Right. Yeah. A Paramahamsa, someone who's on the topmost level of sannyas, they don't need a danda.
住在 sannyasi 的最高位的 Paramahamsa 是不需要拿 danda 棒的。
There are four stages of sannyas.
作为 sannyasi 来讲呢，一共有四个阶段。
Kutujak, Bahudak, Kutijak, Bahudak.Paribrajakacharya, Paribrajakacharya,
Paribrajakacharya,
and Paramahamsa.
然后呢，最后一个阶段就是 Paramahamsa.
So on the Paramahamsa level, they don't use a danda because they just stay in one place. They don't move around much.
但呢，当他们处于 Paramahamsa 至尊天鹅的这个阶段的时候呢，他就不需要拿棍儿，因为他只是在一个地方待着，他不会太多的移动走动。
And another reason was Lord Nityananda broke it into three because Lord Chaitanya had taken the Ekadanda, they'd given him one rod, but he is actually a Vaishnava sannyasi, so Lord Nityananda made it into three, a tree dandi.
还有另外一个呢，是朱尼天丹的把这根棍呢给撅成了三瓣儿。的原因呢，是由于水车丹娘嘛，包括他在接受三西启迪的时候呢，他拿的是一个艾克棍儿，就是只有一根的这个棒子。但实际上呢，他是 Vaishnava， 所以呢，朱车丹娘妈妈不把他给撅成了一个 tree 丹的，就是三节的棍子。
So when Lord Chaitanya found out that they lost his danda and it was broken.Then Lord Chaitanya was upset with them and he was a little angry and sad because he said, that's the only thing I have.
So, when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu found that this stick was broken, he was a little angry and a little sad because he said, this is the only thing I have. But now he has been broken.
Because he'd taken sannyasi, left everything, given up everything, and they'd given him the sannyasi danda.So that was all he had, but now they've lost it. They hadn't taken care of it, so he was upset.
Because when he accepted sannyasi 启迪的时候呢，他其他的所有的东西都被拿走了，唯一得来的就是这根棍儿。可是这根棍儿呢，还被撅断了，所以呢，他就觉得他没有把他这根棍儿好好的照顾好，所以他就心里头不舒服。
So he said, "I don't want to go with you to Jagannath Puri Temple. I'm going to go on my own."He said, either you can go first or I will go first.
So, he said, I don't want to go with you to Jagannath Puri Temple. I want to go myself. Otherwise, you go first. Otherwise, I go first. We can't go together.
So, the devotees told him, you go ahead first.
Then the devotees said, then you go first.
So, Lord Chaitanya ran.Ahead, he went because he's very eager to go and see Lord Jagannath. So he ran away from Lord Nityananda and the other devotees, and he ran to Jagannath Puri Temple.
Because Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is very eager to see Lord Jagannath, so he went to Jagannath Temple and ran to Jagannath Puri Temple. He ran from Lord Nityananda and from all the devotees and all the volunteers.
Many miles away, they could see the roof, the top of the Jagannath temple, and.
然后从好几英里以外的地方呢，就能够看到加格纳庙的庙顶了。
So Lord Chaitanya was becoming very eager to come to get to the temple and to have darshan of Lord Jagannath.
所以呢，所以查丹尼玛巴布呢，他就变得非常的渴望的，想要来到加克纳的庙，然后能够 darshan 主加克纳。
So he came running into the temple, and he got in the temple, and when he saw Lord Jagannath, he wanted to embrace Jagannath.
所以呢，他就跑啊跑，就跑到了加克纳庙里面，然后呢，他就跑到了这个庙里以后呢，他就看到了加克纳的神像，然后他就想要去拥抱主加克纳。
But he fainted on the floor.
但是他倒在了地上。
Yeah, he fainted, he lost consciousness.
他晕倒在了地上，失去了知觉。
So in the temple, there was this one very senior devotee, one man who is very senior. He's in charge of the temple, the head priest. His name was Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
那在庙里面呢，有一位非常年长的长者，他是庙里面的首席祭司。那他的名字呢是 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya.
Bhattacharya means somebody is a Brahmin. He's very learned, very educated, very high class.
Bhattacharya 的意思呢，就是他是非常的博学的，而且呢，他也受到了很好的教育，而且呢，他也这个。 就是非常的德高望重。So,
when Lord Chaitanya fainted, there are some people there in the temple, and their job is to take care of all the people, all the crowds. And if anybody creates any disturbance, or if they try to get too near to the deities, then they can beat them. They have sticks and they can beat the person.
那主Chaitanya妈妈呢，就晕过去了。 但是在庙里面呢，有一些维持治安的人，这些人呢，他就是为了要去，设法就是不要让在庙里面有人来捣乱呐，或者是有人要在这儿惹事儿啊。如果是有这样的人的话呢，他们手里有棍儿，是可以去打这些人的。So
when they saw Lord Chaitanya faint like that, they came forward to beat him.
对的，当他们看到主柴丹尼马巴布这样晕过去以后呢，这些拿着棍儿的人就来打柴丹尼马巴布。
And this Bhattacharya, he was very surprised when he saw Lord Chaitanya come in the temple.
但是呢，当Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya看到了Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu进到庙里以后呢，他感到非常的惊讶。Because
he was not an old man, he was young, and he was very tall, and he was very handsome, and he was in so much ecstasy.
因为这个人呢，他不老，他是一个很年轻的人，长得又如此的高大英俊，而且还有这么多的极乐。Of
course, he's in dress of sannyas, saffron cloth with the shaved head, so he can see he's a renounced person.
那当然，他可以看出他因为穿着sannyasi的衣服，而且呢，头发也是剃得光光的。 所以呢，他可以看出他是一个气绝者。So,
the Bhattacharya wouldn't let these people beat him, but Lord Chaitanya stayed unconscious for a long time.
但是，所以呢，这位 Bhattacharya 呢就不允许这些打手们打 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。但是呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就处在这种昏迷的状态很长时间。And
it came time for offering the bhoga to Lord Jagannath.
然后到了要向主迦那的供奉Boga的时间。So
the Bhattacharya thought what to do. Lord Chaitanya is lying on the floor unconscious. So he had some of his, Bhattacharya had some disciples. And so he got some of his disciples to carry the body of Lord Chaitanya and to take him to his home.
这Bhattacharya就在想这怎么办呢? 因为是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就这么昏迷的躺在这个庙堂里面，所以呢，他就让他的门徒把主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这个身体给搬起来，然后把他给搬到了他自己的家里。Yeah,
Lord Chaitanya. So Bhattacharya, he has a house just beside the temple because he's one of the main people. He has to oversee many of the activities in the temple, so he was living just near to the temple.
So
he was surprised. Lord Chaitanya was unconscious for so long. And then he looked and he saw that his stomach was not moving, he was not breathing. So he was very worried, what's wrong? Maybe he's left the body.
所以说呢，巴达查尔他就很担心，因为Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的后面的时间实在太长了，而他在观察他呢，就发现他的这个胃的这个地方其实都没有呼吸了，所以呢，他就有点担心，他觉得他不会有事儿吧，不会已经离开躯体了吧。Then
he got the Bhattacharya, then he got some pieces of cotton, and he put them in front of Lord Chaitanya's nose, and he saw that there was a little breath there.
然后呢 巴达查尔他又拿了一小块棉絮，拿了一小块棉花， 给放在Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的鼻息底下， 然后呢就发现还是有点呼吸的。
So then Bhattacharya, he could understand that this was a very special form of ecstasy due to love of Krishna, which the sannyasi was experiencing.
所以巴达查尔他就理解了，这位Sanyasi他所体验的是一种由于对 Krishna的爱而导致的很特别的一种极乐的征兆。And
he saw that the kind of ecstasy which he was going through, it's very uncommon, it's only seen in the bodies of eternally liberated devotees.
也呢，就是他的这种征兆呢，是非常的特别的，这种只有在那种 永恒解脱了的奉献者的躯体上才能够显现出来的征兆。And
the Bhattacharya he'd never seen like this in a human being before. He understood this very special.
而巴达达瑞呢，他从来就没有在人类的躯体上见过展现出的这种征兆，所以呢，他知道这是很特别的。So
the Bhattacharya was thinking what to do. At that time, all the devotees of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda and the other devotees, they came to Jagannath Puri temple.
然后巴达查尔就在想，那怎么办呢？与此同时呢，其他那些奉献者，诸尼提亚南达还有其他那些奉献者们，这会儿也都已经赶到了扎古纳兹的庙。And
when they came in the Jagannath temple, they were surprised. They couldn't see Lord Chaitanya anywhere.
但是当他们来到迦叶那庙里以后呢，他们就觉得很奇怪，因为他们在哪都见不到主Chaitanya。But
they heard the people talking that this sannyasi had come to see Lord Jagannath and he'd fallen unconscious.
但是呢，他们就听到旁边有人在说呢，说来了一位sannyasi，来搭讪主Jagannath，但是呢，他却在极乐中失去了知觉。And
they heard he'd been taken to the home of this Bhattacharya.
而且呢，他们也听说呢，他已经被送到了巴达查尔的家里。So
of course, Lord Nityananda, other devotees, they knew this must be Lord Chaitanya.
当然，主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu，主Nityananda Prabhu还有其他的奉献者都知道，他们讲的这个人一定是主Chaitanya。So
it was at that time, this the brother-in-law of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, the Bhattacharya, he has one brother-in-law, they're all married, you know, and their wife was the sister of the Gopinathacharya.
那此时呢，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya呢，他有一位妹夫，那么是Gopinathacharya，然后呢，Gopinathacharya，he is from
He's from Nadia, means over beside Navadvip.
那这个Gopinathacharya呢，他是来自于Nadia的，Nadia是在Navadvip边上。So
he was a devotee of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he knew about the identity of Lord Chaitanya.
所以Gopinathacharya呢，因为他是主Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的奉献者，所以呢，他是能够认出是Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的身份的。And
he was also, he had been a friend with Mukunda, who was coming with Lord Nityananda, so they knew each other.
而且呢，他也是Mukunda的好朋友。那Mukunda呢，是和Nityananda Prabhu一起来的，所以他们大家都认识。Yeah,
Mukunda offered obeisances to Gopinathacharya.
Mukunda 呢向 Gopinath 的 Acharya 顶拜。
And the Acharya embraced him, and he asked about Lord Chaitanya.
然后 Acharya 呢就拥抱了 Mukunda， 并且呢开始询问关于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的信息。
And so then Mukunda said, "Well, I've come here with Lord Chaitanya. He's here."
然后 Mukunda 说，我是和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 一起来的，他应该在这儿啊。
And then, of course, Gopinath Acharya saw Lord Nityananda. So then he offered obeisances to Lord Nityananda.
然后呢 ，Gopinath Acharya 呢就见到了主尼提亚南达，然后他向主尼提亚南达顶拜。
So then they said about Lord Chaitanya, they've taken sannyas and he's come here to Jagannath Puri, and we have all come with him.
然后就对他说呢，因为 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢，他接受了sannyasi的启迪。然后呢，他来到 Puri 想拜见主 Jagannath， 所以我们就和他一起来了。
But Lord Chaitanya came on his own first, and we can't find him. We don't know where he is. But we hear that he may be in the house of the Bhattacharya.
但是呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他自己先来到这里。可是我们来了这儿以后呢，哪儿都找不到他。但是我们听说呢，他来到了 Bhattacharya 的家里。
And we heard Lord Chaitanya became unconscious when he saw Jagannath, and the Bhattacharya took him to his home to help him to get him recovered.
我们听说呢，当他见到了主Jagannath 的时候呢，他就失去了知觉。然后后来我们听说他又被送到了 Bhattacharya 的家里面，来帮助他能够恢复过来。
So they said, "You should let's all go to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya's home." And see Lord Chaitanya.
然后就说到了，那咱们大家都上 Bhattacharya 的家里面去见见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
And then we'll come and see Jagannath.
然后呢，我们再回来拜见主 Jagannath.
So that Gopinath Acharya took all the devotees to the home of the Bhattacharya.
所以呢 ，Gopinath Acharya 呢就把所有的奉献者都带到了 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 的家里。
Lord Chaitanya was still unconscious. He had not regained consciousness yet, so devotees were feeling very unhappy.
但此时呢，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 依然处在昏迷的状态，他还没有恢复他的知觉。那这会儿奉献者们就觉得挺伤心的。
They were happy to see him, but they were sorry that he was unconscious.
他们能够见到主，他们很开心。但是呢，主是处在这种没有知觉的状态，他们觉得很悲伤。
So Sarvabhauma met all the devotees, and he saw Lord Nityananda, and he offered obeisances to Lord Nityananda.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢，他就见了所有的这些奉献者们，他见到了主尼提亚南达，他向主尼提亚南达顶拜。
So Bhattacharya said, "Maybe better first you go and see Lord Jagannath, and then come back and see Lord Chaitanya, see if you should cover." Let's give him more time.
Bhattacharya 就对他们建议说呢，要不然你们先去拜见主 Jagannath， 然后呢再回来见主 Chaitanya， 再给主 Chaitanya 一些时间，让他能够恢复知觉。
So they all went to see Lord Jagannath. They were all in ecstasy, and Lord Nityananda especially. He was in ecstasy to see Lord Jagannath. Nearly fainted. He also nearly fainted.
所以呢，所有的这些奉献者们呢，就全部都去 darshan 主 Jagannath 了。然后主 Nityananda 呢，也是非常的极乐的，所有的人都处在极乐之中。但是主 Nityananda 呢，是尤其的处在极乐之中。当他见到主 Jagannath 的时候，他也基本上就要晕过去了。
They brought a nice garland from Lord Jagannath to put around the neck of Lord Nityananda.
然后呢，他们就从主 Jagannath 的身上摘下一串非常美的花环，并且把这花环呢就献给了主尼提亚南达。
Then they all went back to see Lord Chaitanya, and this time when they went back, they all chanted the holy names. They had some kirtan.
然后呢，所有的奉献者又回到了 Bhattacharya 的家里面来重新的来拜见主。然后这次呢，他们进行了极乐的 kirtan。
And then Lord Chaitanya came back to consciousness.
就这样呢，使主尼提主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 恢复了他的知觉。
And Lord Chaitanya he chants the holy name with all the devotees, and Bhattacharya, he takes the dust from the feet of Lord Chaitanya.
然后呢, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢, 就和所有的这些奉献者们一起进行唱诵圣名, 然后 Bhattacharya呢, 从主的莲花足上取下了他的尘土。
So then Bhattacharya said, today I will arrange all of you to get Mahaprasadam from Lord Jagannath. You please first go take your bath, come back and have prasadam here.
然后, Bhattacharya就说呢, 今天我要给大家安排来自于 Jagannath的 Mahaprasadam. 现在呢, 你们先去沐浴, 等沐浴之后呢, 再回来, 趁着来荣耀prasadam。
So when you go to Jagannath Puri, take bath means you go bathe in the sea. You go to the sea and take bath.
那在Jagannath Puri沐浴也就意味着是要到海洋里去沐浴。
Means a salt water bath.
那也就意味着是要进行一个咸水浴。
So Bhattacharya, he arranged, because he's one of the main men in the temple, so he could get all the Mahaprasadam, and he brought nice prasadam to serve all the devotees.
那因为Bhattacharya呢，他是 这庙里的大主管，所以说呢，他就能够弄到非常好的Mahaprasadam，所以呢，他就弄来了很丰盛的Mahaprasadam来派给这些奉献者们。Yeah,
special rice and very good vegetables and serve everything on a golden plate.
然后有非常高质量的米饭，烹制的很美味的蔬菜，并且呢，这些Prasadam全部都是用金子，就是。 用金色的盘子盛着，然后来派给奉献者的。So
Lord Chaitanya said, I will just take some boiled vegetables. Just give me the boiled vegetables.
就Chaitanya Mahaprabhu说呢，你只是给我一些煮蔬菜就好了。
You give all those cakes and sweet preparations with the condensed milk. You give them all to the devotees. Don't give to me.
把这些油。 这个炼制的，就是由精炼的炼乳所制成的这些甜品，还有这些蛋糕啊，给奉献者们吧，不要给我，我不吃这些。But
Bhattacharya said, you just take whatever Lord Jagannath has eaten. This is all Jagannath prasadam.
但是 Bhattacharya 对他说呢，你就吃下所有主 Jagannath 所吃的这些食物，因为所有这些 prasadam 都是主 Jagannath 的 prasadam。
So he made them all eat the cakes and the condensed milk preparations, and they had a nice feast.
所以说呢，大家就都所以呢，就使主吃下了这个蛋糕，还有由这个凝乳所制成的所有的这些甜品，所以这是一个非常好的大餐。
And so then after they took, after devotees had finished, then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and Gopinath Acharya, they took lunch. Because they've been serving the lunch, so after the devotees all finished, then they sat down and they took their lunch.
然后在所有的奉献者都荣耀完Prasadam之后呢，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya和Gopinath Acharya他们才坐下来，在荣耀他们的午餐，因为之前他们是在服务所有其他的奉献者们。Then
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya comes to speak to Lord Chaitanya, and he says to him, Namo Narayan. I offer my obeisances to you who are Lord Narayan.
然后呢，当这个Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya吃饱饭以后呢，他就来到了Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu的面前，并且对他说呢，Namo Narayan, 我向您致以我前进的顶礼，您是至尊人各守神主Narayana。
Right. Mayavadi sannyasis, when they meet each other, they will say Namo Narayanaya. That you are Narayan, they offer, they respect people. When they take sannyas in the Mayavadi line, they take sannyas to become one with Narayan.
那么当Mayavadi的sannyasi,他们在彼此相互顶礼的时候,他们就会说 Namo Narayana. 因为当他们接受为sannyasi之后呢,他们觉得他们和主Narayana就合一了。
Namo Narayanaya. Namo Naranaya. Namo Naranaya.
Naranaya.
Right? This is a Mayavadi greeting. Because he saw Lord Chaitanya looks like a Mayavadi sannyasi. He's got this, he's no Sikha, he's no Brahmin thread, so he looks like a Mayavadi sannyasi.
And he'd
taken sannyas from Keshava Bharati, who was a Mayavadi sannyasi. So he thought this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu must be a Mayavadi sannyasi. But Lord Chaitanya said to him, he doesn't say Namo Narayanaya, he says, Krishner Matir Astu, let your attraction be to Krishna, may your mind be on Krishna. Krishne Matir Astu.
Krishne Matir Astu.
Right, when people ask a devotee for blessings, we will say to them, Krishne Matir Astu, may your mind always remember Krishna.
那所以呢，当一位人向奉献者去祈求祝福的时候，我们总是说 Krishna Matir Astu， 愿你的心意总是专注于 Krishna。
So when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya heard this, he understood, oh, Chaitanya is a Vaishnava sannyasi.
所以呢，当萨巴巴玛巴达查尔听到这一句话以后呢，他就明白了，哦，所以查坦尼玛巴布他是一位瓦什纳巴的三亚子。So
he asked about what happened to Lord Chaitanya? How is it he's become a sannyasi? What was he doing before?
那所以呢，他就开始询问了，这位所以查坦尼他是怎么成为一名三亚子的呢？他在成为三亚子之前，他在做什么呢？
So Gopinath tells about who is the father and where does he come from. Right, who knows the name? Lord Chaitanya's father? Anybody remember?
有没有人记得?
What?
Jagannath
Mishra. Jagannath Mishra, yeah. So Mishra is the name, it means a Brahmin, Brahmana family. If you're not a Brahmana by birth, you cannot take sannyas in the Sankaracharya, in the Mayavadi line. They won't give you sannyas unless you're a Brahmana. So, Gopinathacharya said this man's Lord Chaitanya's father was Jagannath Mishra, and he was from Navadvip. And Lord Chaitanya is the son of this Jagannath Mishra. Before sannyas, his name was Vishwambar Mishra.
Mishra.
Right. Lord Chaitanya was known as Vishwambar, and the family name Mishra.
所以朱彩丹的妈妈和之前的名字呢是 Vishwamba， 然后她的家就是她的姓是 Mishra。
And Lord Chaitanya's mother is who？
朱彩丹的妈妈的母亲是谁啊？
妈妈。
What's the name? Mother Sachi, right? Sachi Mata.
Sachi Mata 是他们母亲的名字。
And Sachi Mata, she's the daughter of Nilambar Chakravarti.
然后 Sachi 妈妈她是 Nilambar Chakravarti 的女儿。
When we go to when you're in Mayapur, you can go and see the place of Belpakor.
那当你在麦普的时候呢，你可以去叫 Belpakor 的这个地方
and there's
看一看。
And the deity, there's a deity there of Madan Gopal.
那在那个地方呢，有 Madan Gopal 的神像。
And that deity is from the family of Nilambar Chakravarti, Sachi's father.
而这尊神像呢，就是来自于 Nilambar Chakravarti 的。就是萨奇的母亲，萨奇妈妈的父亲家里的神像。
Very beautiful Krishna deity, and worship is still done by one of the descendants of the family of Nilambar Chakravarti.
那么这个神像呢是非常美的 Krishna 的神像，那现在呢依然还是被 Nilambar Chakravarti 的后人们在很好的崇拜着。
So when the Bhattacharya heard.He said, oh, he said, Nilambar Chakravarti was the classmate. He's in the same class as my father. And Jagannath Mishra,He was respected by my father.
而 Jagannath Mishra 呢，他被我的父亲也尊重着。
So I also respect Jagannath Mishra and Nilambar Chakravarti.
所以说呢，我对于 Jagannath Mishra 和Nilambar Chakravarti 也都是非常的尊重的。
So I also must have great, I have respect now for this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以呢，我现在也必须要对这位是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 有很大的尊重之心。
So he told Lord Chaitanya, he said, "You are very respectable. You're from a very good family, and now you're a sannyasi. I want to be your servant."
然后呢，他就对这位是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，说您是非常的令人尊敬的，而且呢，您来自一个非常德高望重的家庭。所以说呢，我想要成为您的仆人。
So the Bhattacharya, he's very much older than Lord Chaitanya, and so Lord Chaitanya, when he heard the Bhattacharya speak like this, then Lord Chaitanya felt he just remembered Vishnu, and he became very humble, and he told him, he said, "You're my teacher."
但是巴达查里亚呢，他的岁数要比水产泰尼马帕布要年长很多，所以说呢，当他一听到巴达查里亚怎么一跟他说以后呢，他立刻心里边就想起了主威士努，然后他就变得非常的谦卑起来。
Yeah, he said you teach Vedanta philosophy, so you're the well wisher of all the sannyasis because you teach them the Vedic knowledge.
他说呢，您是我的老师，因为呢，您在教授的是维丹塔的哲学。那您是所有的这些散亚系的祝福者，因为您把这维丹塔的伟大的知识教给了大家。
Shankaracharya, he established four temples. There were four of his ashrams in different parts of India.
Shankaracharya 在印度的不同地方。建了四座庙，所以呢，他有四个修院。
So one of them was at Jagannath Puri, and the idea is when people take sannyas, they can go there and study the Vedas, and they'll be taught.
那么其中的一座修院呢，就是在 Jagannath Puri。那这个他建他的这个目的呢，就是当人们接受 sannyas 启迪之后呢，就可以到这个地方去研习伟达知识。
And Bhattacharya would teach them. He would teach the sannyasis the philosophy.
所以说呢 ，Bhattacharya 呢，他就会。向这些 sannyasi 们传授哲学。
So Lord Chaitanya said, I'm just a young sannyasi. I don't know what is good and what is bad.
就是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我只不过是一个年轻的少不更事的 sannyasi， 我根本就不知道什么是对的，什么是错的，什么是好的，什么是坏的。
I take shelter of you. I accept you as my guru.
所以呢，我要托庇于您，我接受您作为我的 guru。
I have just come here to be with you, to associate with you.
我只是来这儿是为了和您在一起，是为了得到您的联谊。
So please, you give me shelter and maintain me.
所以呢，请您给我庇护，并且呢，请您维系我。
I'm very sorry about what happened today. I fainted in the temple, but you've been very kind to me. You took care of me.
那我对今天在庙里发生的事情呢也感到很抱歉，我在庙里面晕过去了，然后呢你把我送到这儿来，你还把我你好好的照顾了我。
So Bhattacharya said, yeah, he said, you in the future don't go alone to the temple, you have to go with some of your devotees.
然后 Bhattacharya 就对他说呢，以后呢你可千万不能独自一个人去庙了。你必须要有你的某一位奉献者陪着你一同前往。
Or I will come with you personally. If I will be with you, no problem.
或者呢，我亲自陪你一起去。如果我要是和你一块儿的话呢，那就没有任何问题了。
But Lord Chaitanya said, "No, I in the future I won't enter the temple. I will just see Lord Jagannath from the Garuda Stamba."
那他说不不，以后呢，我再也不去加格纳庙了。我只是从 Garuda Stamba 那个地方呢。
Right, just like in Mayapur we have Garuda also. Garuda is outside the temple. If you stand at the Garuda Stamba, you won't see the deities.
You won't, or you can.
In Mayapur you can, but in Puri you can. If you stand at the Garuda Stamba in Puri, you can see Jagannath.
Okay, okay. 是这样的，就在咱们的 Mayapur 也是有这个 Garuda 是在庙外头。但如果要是站在这个 Garuda Stamba 上面的话呢，是没有办法看到神像的。但是在 Jagannath 庙这个地方，如果是站在 Garuda Stamba 这个地方，是能够看到 Jagannath 的神像的。
Usually the Garuda is on a pillar. Stamba means a pillar, so it's on a pillar and it's at the back of the temple.
因为这个 Stamba 的意思呢，就是柱子的意思。那么Garuda 呢，它是在这个柱子上，而且这根由Garuda 所待的这根柱子呢，是在庙的后面。
One time, Lord Chaitanya was there at the temple and he was looking at Jagannath, and there were so many people in front to see Jagannath that one old lady she couldn't see the deity, so she climbed on Lord Chaitanya to see the deity.
那有一次呢，是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他在 Jagannath 庙里面在达成神像，那当时呢有好多人都要去达成神像。很多人因为人太多了都看不见，当时有一个老太太她要看神像，可是怎么也看不见，她就爬到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的身上去看 Jagannath 的神像。
Lord Chaitanya was standing beside the Garuda Stamba, so she was able to climb up on top of Lord Chaitanya and hold on to the Garuda Stamba and see Jagannath.
当时呢 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 呢就站在了 Garuda 的这根柱子边上 Stamba 的边上，然后呢就使得这老太太呢，她就能够攀着这个柱子，就这么一下就爬到了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的身上，然后呢一边抓着柱子，一边站在 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的身上，一边看着神像。
Lord Chaitanya didn't mind, he didn't take any offense. He said, "Oh, he said it's very good. She's so eager to see Lord Jagannath."
那 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对这件事情呢，他其实一点也不介意，因为他能够看到这位老太太她。非常的热切的想要看到 Sri Jagannath， 所以说呢，他觉得这是一个挺好的征兆。
So, but they made arrangements where the different devotees should stay, so that they could, you know, come to Jagannath Puri. So they make up arrangements for Lord Chaitanya and the different devotees where they can stay, and where they can take bath and water and everything.
然后呢，他们就为这些奉献者们做了一些安排，因为呢，他们要来到Jagannath Puri，然后要拜见主，所以呢，就给他们安排了住的地方呀，还有就他们去沐浴的地方呀，他们可以取水的地方等等。And
then the next morning, they went to see Lord Jagannath. In morning, wake up the deity. They go to see the worship.
然后第二天清晨呢，因为要有唤醒主降下的仪式，所以呢，他们就到这个庙里面去。 参加这个敬拜的仪式，崇拜的仪式。So
then the Bhattacharya was talking to Gopinath Acharya about Lord Chaitanya and said, this sannyasi is very humble by nature and he's also very handsome. So I'm very attached to him. I like him very much.
然后Bhattacharya呢，就和Gopinath Acharya就开始聊起了这位sannyasi。他说呢，这位sannyasi他的本性非常的谦卑，而且呢，他也长得如此的英俊，我非常的喜欢他，我现在很依附他。Who
gave him sannyas? What sampradaya is he coming in? And what's his sannyasi name?
他是谁给他的sannyasi启迪呢？他是来自于哪个 sampradaya 的呢？他这个名字是谁给他的呢？
So Gopinath Acharya says his name is Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya. And his sannyasi guru was Keshava Bharati. Right. Lord Chaitanya took his sannyas at Katwa, which is across the Ganga from Mayapur.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is in Katwa, which is from Mayapur.
So from the name, the Bhattacharya can understand different things about the sannyas of Lord Chaitanya, about his sannyas initiation.
通过他的Sanyasi这个名字呢，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya就能够了解一些Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu他所得到的这个Sanyasi启迪的一些情况。He
said, so Bhattacharya said, this first name, Sri Krishna, this is very good name. He said, this very nice name.
Bhattacharya说呢，他这个名字的前半部分，Sri Krishna，这是一个非常好的名字。
But he kept it, but his name Chaitanya, this is the name of the Brahmachari, that he's kept the Brahmachari name. And he's also from the Bharati community, because his guru was Keshava Bharati. So Bharati means second class sannyas.
而且呢，他也是来自于巴尔提社团的，因为他的guru呢是Keshava Bharati，但是巴尔提的意思呢是第二阶层的sannyasi。
Yeah, there's different names. Some names are first class, some names are second class, and some names are third class in the Mayavadi Sampradaya. Only in the Mayavadi.
在Mayavadi的Sampradaya里面呢，能够有从名字上分出不同的类别。 有的是一类的名字，有的是二级的名字，有的是三级的名字。
So Gopinath, he's a devotee, and he says, Lord Chaitanya doesn't have to take sannyas on in any special sampradaya. He's first class. He's beyond all that. He's transcendental to all the second and first class.
然后呢，Gopinath，因为Gopinath Acharya，因为他是一位奉献者，他就说呢，Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，他其实他本身他就是一类的，他本来他就是超然的，所以呢，他根本就不受在任何一个 Sampradaya 的这个传系中的管束。
But Bhattacharya said this, Lord Chaitanya, see, Chaitanya, he is still a young man. It will be very hard for him to keep the principles of sannyas. So, what I can do to help him, I can recite Vedanta philosophy to him. I will teach him the Vedanta to help him to become fixed in his renunciation.
那我能够帮他什么呢？我可以来教授他维丹塔的哲学，从而呢能够帮助他稳定的处在他的原则之中。
Bhattacharya is a Mayavadi. He's a Mayavadi. So he says, I will teach him the philosophy of Vedanta so it will fix him in monism and oneness, in the philosophy of oneness.
然后呢，Bhattacharya因为他是一位Mayavadi 的学者，所以呢，他说呢，我会传授他维丹塔，但是呢，我会帮助他稳处在一元论的这个体系之中。
And the Bhattacharya also said, you know, he said, what we can do, I can give him sannyas again, and we'll give him new cloth, and we'll do the sannyas ceremony again, and I will make him into a first class sampradaya.
然后巴达夏人说呢，而且呢，我们还可以再次给他重新进行一次三亚寺的启迪，然后呢，我们会给他重新这个新的衣服，然后呢，让他重新的成为一类的僧伽大的三亚寺。
So Gopinathacharya tells Bhattacharya, you don't understand Lord Chaitanya. You don't know that he's actually the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
然后Gopinathacharya就对Asura Mahabhatacharya说呢，说你根本就不了解这位Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu他到底是谁，根本就不知道他到底是谁，你不知道他是至尊人格首身本人。
Lord Chaitanya, he's not an ordinary person. He's not just some sannyasi like in the material world. He's the Lord himself.
对，所以Chaitanya Mahaprabhu呢，他可不是一个普通人，他可不是一个在这个物质世界里面的随便的一位sannyasi，他是主本人。So
when Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and his disciples heard this, they said, well, what evidence is there to prove this, that Chaitanya is the Supreme Lord?
那有什么证据能够证明他就是至尊人格首神呢？
And Gopinathacharya says, well, we have the statements of the acharyas who understand the Supreme Lord. They are the proof.
然后呢，这个Gopinathacharya说呢，那么我们有那些能够了解至尊人格首神的acharya的陈述。 那么从这个陈述里面，能够证实Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就是至尊人格首神。But
the disciples of the Bhattacharya, they say, oh, we get our knowledge of the truth by hypothesis, by logical hypothesis, by using our mind to speculate, to understand.
然后呢，就是Bhattacharya的这些门徒们就说，我们是通过 我们逻辑的分析，还有这个假设的推敲，来了解绝对真理的，来了解这个最高的知识的。But
Gopinathacharya said, you cannot get real knowledge just by argument, just by using your mind like this.
然后Gopinathacharya就说呢，你不可能只是用你的心意的。
If you really want to understand God, you have to get His mercy, not just by your mind or by your speculation.
如果你要想真要是了解神的话，你必须要从神那儿得到仁慈才可以了解，而不仅仅是只是通过你自己的心意推敲就能够了解了。If
you get even a little mercy, a little bit of favor, of devotional service, then you can understand the nature of God.
如果你要是能够从奉爱服务中得到一点点滋味，得到一点点仁慈的话，那你就能够了解他是地藏人格受身了。
So the Gopinath tells Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, you may be a great scholar and a teacher with many disciples.
对 Gopinath Acharya 就对 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说呢，说您可能是一个非常伟大的学者，而且呢，您可能也是一位伟大的老师，而且呢，有很多的门徒追随者。
Actually, it said this Bhattacharya, he was the incarnation of Brihaspati.Who is the guru of the demigods?
事实上呢，据说呢，这位就是说，书中提到呢，说这位Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 他是 Brihaspati 的化身。Brihaspati 呢是所有的半神人们的 guru。
But Gopinath Acharya told Bhattacharya, he said, you don't have even a little bit of the mercy of the Lord, so you cannot understand him.Even though he's with you in your home.
但是 Gopinath Acharya 说呢，你从主那儿连丁点仁慈都没有得到，所以呢，你根本就没有办法理解主。即便是主现在就在你的旁边，在你们家里住着。
It's not your fault. You cannot understand God simply by being a scholar, just simply by studying.
但这不是你的错，您不能够了解主呢。就您不能够只是通过自己是一个学者，只是通过学习就能够了解主了。
So Bhattacharya says, well, what is the proof that you have got the mercy of the Lord?
然后 Bhattacharya 说，那怎么能够证明您是得到了主的仁慈呢？
So he says, knowledge of the absolute truth is evidence of the mercy of the Lord.I know that I know about God. I know the absolute truth.
他说呢，就是关于这绝对真理的知识，他就已经是证实了。因为我知道这绝对真理的知识，所以就已经意味着我得到了主的仁慈。
You saw Lord Chaitanya when he was in ecstasy, when he collapsed in front of the deities. You've seen these symptoms.These symptoms in the body, they indicate he's not of this world.
比如说你看到了去查丹尼玛法布，当他在神像面前由于极乐而失去知觉倒在地上的时候，他所展现出来的这些真相本来就不是在这个世间能够见到的真相。
You saw everything, you saw all the things that the effect on his body, how he was hardly breathing, how he was unconscious like that.But you cannot recognize this. This is your illusion.
比如说，你看到了他的身体所展现出来的这种真相，看到了他没有办法恢复他的知觉，以及他好像都已经没有呼吸了。但是呢，你是没有，但是你没有办法把这个理解成是他的这个极乐。所以说呢，这是你的问题，因为你是处在虚幻的幻象之中。
So.Bhattacharya says, yeah, we're just having a discussion, don't get angry. I'm just speaking about the Shastra. Don't get upset, don't take any offense.
然后 Bhattacharya 说，咱们这儿其实就在这儿聊天呢，我就是跟您探讨一下这些话题，您别生气，别动怒呀。我只不过呢，就是在讲这经典中的这个内容而已。
I agree, Lord Chaitanya is certainly a great, very special devotee.But I cannot accept him as an incarnation of Lord Vishnu.
我毫无疑问，我接受Sri Chaitanya他是一位很特别的奉献者，但是我没有办法接受他是 Vishnu 的化身。
In the Kali Yuga, there's no incarnation of Vishnu. The Lord only comes in three yugas. He's known as Tri Yuga.
在卡利年代根本就没有 Vishnu 的化身。主他只是在三个年代里面显现，所以他被认为是 Tri Yuga.
This is stated in the scriptures. The Lord doesn't come in the Kali Yuga.
在经典里面就是这么说的，主根本就没有在卡利年代显现。
So when Gopinath Acharya heard this, he became very unhappy, and he said, "You're supposed to know the Vedic scriptures. Don't you know better than this?"
然后呢 Gopinath Acharya 一听到这话之后呢就很不爽了，他就说你本来是应该很了解经典中的内容的，难道你 不能够比这些内容了解的更多了吗？
Srimad Bhagavatam and the Mahabharat, two very important scriptures, you have not studied them?
经典不叫瓦坛还有 Mahabharat, 这都是非常重要的经典，难道你不研习这些经典吗？
It describes here how the Lord appears in every age and he does come in the Kali Yuga.
那么在这里面都说了主他是在每一个年代他都会显现的，他的确在卡里年代显现了。
There's no Lila Avatar, but there's Yuga Avatar.
没有 Lila Avatar, 但是的确是有 Yuga Avatar 的。
What's an avatar? Who knows the meaning avatar?
请问哪位奉献者知道 avatar 的意思是什么？
化身。
Incarnation.
Well, we say in simple language, one who comes down, he comes from the spiritual world.
那我们如果用简单的话来说呢，就是那个从灵性世界下来的人。
Right, one who comes down.
就是一个从灵性世界下来的人。
So there are different kinds of avatars.
所以呢，有不同的 avatar.
There are lila avatars, incarnations for the pastimes.
那有 Lila Avatar, 也就是为了要上演逍遥时光而显现的化身。
And then there's Guna Avatars, incarnations in charge of the different modes of nature.
还有呢 Guna Avatar, 这个 Avatar 呢它是要掌管不同的物质自然属性的化身。
And there are Purusha Avatars for the creation.
还有呢 Purusha Avatar, 它是为了创造而显现的化身。
And then there is also Shaktavesha Avatar, empowered incarnations.
还有 Shaktavesha Avatar, 这些是被赋予了力量的化身。
So, Lord Chaitanya, actually there's incarnation in every age. In every age the Lord comes, because there's Yuga Avatar in every age.
那最后呢，在每一个年代其实都是有化身的，就是主他都会来的，因为他在每一个年代都会有 Yuga Avatar。
So when they say there's no incarnation in the Kali Yuga, it means no Lila Avatar.
所以呢，当说在卡利年代没有主的化身的时候，他的意思是说在卡利年代没有主的 Lila Avatar 的显现。
But there's still Yuga Avatar.
但是呢，依然还是有 Yuga Avatar 年代化身。
So, Bhattacharya is telling the Bhattacharya, you don't know the philosophy.
对 Gopinath Acharya 就对 Bhattacharya 说呢，你根本就不懂哲学。
There is an incarnation in every age, but your heart has become so hard, you're not understanding all these facts.
那么在这个每个年代是有年代的化身显现的，但是呢由于你的心实在太硬了，所以你就没有办法去理解所有的这些事实。
Just like in the time of Lord Krishna's birth, when they brought Gargamuni there to tell about the previous life of Lord Krishna, he identified how this child appeared in different colors.
In different colors, right?
Yeah, different colors in different ages.
Yeah, 那么就像当Sri Krishna 出生之后呢，他们把 Gargamuni 给请去来为 Krishna 来讲述他之前的这个身世的时候，那么这个 Gargamuni 他就讲述了 Krishna 他如何在之前的不同的年代以不同的颜色显现。
In the Satya Yuga, the Lord comes in a white color.
在 Satya 年代呢，主他是以白色的颜色显现的。
And then Treta Yuga, it comes in a red color.
在 Treta 年代呢，他的皮肤是红色的。
And then in the Dwapara Yuga, he comes in this blackish color as Krishna.
那么在Dwapara 年代的时候呢，他就是以这种蓝黑色的颜色 ，Krishna 的这个颜色显现的。
And he also comes in a yellow color.
但是呢，他也以黄色的肤色显现。
Just like in the Kali Yuga, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is known as Gauranga, one who has a golden colored body.
那么就像在这个卡利年代，属于查丹尼亚马法布来了，他的他被以这个 Gauranga 而著称，也就是说呢，主有金色的肤色。
So this way there is predictions about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming in the Kali Yuga.
那么所以呢，就以这样的方式呢，的确是有预言，所以 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是会在卡利年代显现的。
In the 11th canto, you have the verse from Karabajana Muni.
那在圣典伯加瓦坛第十一篇里面呢，有一个由 Karabajana Muni 所说的一个事件。
There was this one king, Nimiraj, King Nimi. He wanted to know about the Lord's incarnations in different ages.
那有一位国王 Nimiraj, 他就希望能够知道主在不同的年代的化身的情况。
So he described how the Lord comes in the Kali Yuga to perform Sankirtan.
那么所以在这里面呢，圣人就描述了主如何在卡利年代前来，并且开始进行 Sankirtan 的活动。
And then in the Mahabharat, there's another verse which is describing about Lord Chaitanya's incarnation.
在 Mahabharat 中呢，也有一个诗节，在这里面呢就描述了 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的这个化身。
And it describes there how the Lord has a golden complexion, and his body is covered with sandalwood pulp.
那在这个诗节里面就描述了主他如何是具有金黄色的肤色，而且他的这个皮肤上呢是盖满了檀香浆液。
He's a householder when he's a young man.
当他是一个年轻人的时候呢，他是一位居士。
And then he takes sannyas, and he's very renounced.
然后呢，他就成为了 sannyasi。成为 sannyasi 之后呢，他变得非常的气绝。
And he is very fixed in devotional service, and he spreads sankirtan.
而且呢，他是非常的坚定的处在奉献服务之中，而且他传播了 sankirtan 运动。
So Gopinath Acharya explains these verses to them that there's evidence there about the Lord coming in the Kali Yuga.
对 ，Gopinath Acharya 呢就。通过解释这些事件，像Sabhavabhattacharya 来告诉他，都是证据，就是在卡利年代的确是有主过来的。
But he says, I'm not going to waste my time arguing with you because you're just a speculator.
但是 Gopinathacharya 说呢，可是我不要把我的时间浪费在和你在争论了，因为你只不过就是一个推敲者而已。
When the Lord will be pleased with you, then you will understand.His identity.
但当主被你所取悦了以后，他那会儿就能够让你了解他真正的身份了。
You need to, you've only got the mercy of Mayavadi philosophers.
可是现在呢，你只是从 Mayavadi 的哲学那得到了恩赐。
So you can only understand about oneness and impersonalism.
那所以说呢，你现在只能够通过非人格主义去了解关于一的话题。
Anyway, nothing is impossible. If you take shelter of Krishna, you can overcome these obstacles.
但是呢，没有什么事是不可能的。如果你要是能够脱避于 Krishna 的话呢，那你就能够逾越所有的这些障碍。
So.The Bhattacharya said, okay, he said, go and get Lord Chaitanya and bring him, invite him to come with all of his associates to ask them, I'm inviting them to come, come and take Jagannath Prasadam.
然后呢 ,Bhattacharya 说呢，那赶紧现在去把 Sri Chaitanya 还有所有的这些奉献者都给请过来，然后呢我请他们荣耀 Jagannath Prasadam.
So Gopinath Acharya thought, tried to teach the Bhattacharya about the position of Lord Chaitanya.
但是呢，Gopinath Acharya 就在想，他要试图要教就是要试图要告诉Sabhavabhattacharya 关于 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的真实的这个身份。
So. Lord Chaitanya he took his prasadam and then he came to see the Bhattacharya.
那然后去这丹德玛法布呢？他首先荣耀了他的 prasadam 之后呢，他就去拜见 Bhattacharya。
So Lord Chaitanya was very respectful to Lord to Bhattacharya because he said, "This man Bhattacharya has been very kind to me. He was very merciful. He took care of me."
然后呢，睡着丹德玛巴布呢，对于这位Bhattacharya 呢是尊重有加，因为他觉得呢，他对他非常的仁慈，他对我这么好，他把我照顾得非常好。
And he's like my father. He wants to protect me.
他像我的父亲一样，他想保护我。
He wants me to be a good sannyasi, so that's good. There's no fault.
那他希望我成为一个好的 sannyasi, 所以这挺好的，这没错。
So the next morning, they went to see Lord Jagannath, and then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya sat down with Lord Chaitanya, and Bhattacharya said, "I will explain to you Vedanta philosophy."
那第二天呢，他们就一块儿去拜见了主Jagannath。之后呢，Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 呢就和 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 一起坐了下来。然后呢，他对 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说呢，我现在呢要传授给你维丹塔的哲学。
For the sannyasi, it's very important. Their main business is to hear.